are back now at 8:11, and today we'll conclude our special series together again, favorite movie cast reunited with the hit Footloose. Hard to believe it was more than 20 years ago that audiences kicked off their Sunday shoes and also learned the name Kevin Bacon. So what was all the fuss about?
Now I gotta cut loose, footloose.
The year 1984.
I thought this was a party! Let's dance!
Famous line, famous song.
Now I gotta cut loose, footloose. Kicked off Sunday shoes.
Footloose. In his breakout role, Kevin Bacon plays Ren, the new kid in a small town.
Is there a Loggins loud music?
Let's watch that attitude, boy.
Loosely based on a real place in America where music and dancing is illegal.
It's illegal. Jump back.
He crosses state lines to show a few what they've been missing. Sporting a punk haircut, Ren is a rebel with a cause.
I would like to move that the law against public dancing within the town limits of Beaumont be abolished.
John Lithgow is the ultra-conservative Reverend Shaw Moore, who desperately wants to protect his daughter Ariel, played by Laurie Singer.
I don't know what I'm going to do with you.
There ain't nothing to do with me, Daddy. You like it or not, this is it.
She's a wild child who supports Ren. He eventually beats the town board with their own tool, quoting from the Bible.
Leaping and dancing before the Lord. Leaping and dancing.
With an infectious soundtrack and dance montages that celebrate the music, Footloose is still kicking today. This is what the cast looked like back in 1984, and here they are today, Kevin Bacon, John Lithgow, and Laurie Singer. Good morning to all of you. There's nothing more fun for us than to, when the clips are playing, look at you guys watching them. And there were times, Kevin, let's be honest, you were kind of doing the old patty curl.
He was doing this, too.
Did you guys have any idea that this would become such a pop culture phenomenon?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I don't think you really know if you're making a movie what's going to happen to it, you know. And, you know, it was unusual because it was a dance movie, but we weren't really singing, so it wasn't really a musical. I mean, they'd kind of done it, I guess, with Saturday Night Fever, but the idea of, you know, taking, you know, really, really strong tunes and sort of building a movie around that was kind of a new thing.
And you almost didn't get the part, right?
Yeah, well, the studio really didn't want me to do the part.
Because?
They didn't think I was sexy. Mm. And, you know...
You worked out pretty well.
I was very lucky because the director of the movie and the producer of the movie were very, very big fans of mine and really wanted me to do the film. And they did a screen test, you know, put their own money up for it. And that was the part.
Yeah. John, you say that in this period of your career, these were some of your favorite and best movies. So what stood out about this movie to you?
Well, it was just done with such verve and style. I was, Diane Wiest and I were kind of the anchor. We were the old guard. But we paid a lot of attention to our characters, too. We wanted to do justice to them and not make them caricatures. Herb Ross was our director, and he took every element of the film seriously. So we knew that as fun as it was going to be, we were going to do justice to it.
A message, Laurie, because so many people talk about the soundtrack from Footloose, but there was a very serious message to the movie as well.
Yeah, I mean, when I first read the script, the words and the feeling just jumped off the page. There's so much passion and feeling, and really it's about what's best in America. It's about freedom, and it's about fighting against even a little bit of oppression, mm-hmm. which is...
But there's a reason for it.
I was oppression. Yeah. I was the great oppressor.
You know, trying to prevent us from dancing, Kevin, can you imagine? And from reading books and all kinds of things. So it's really about, you know, about fighting the good fight in America, about freedom and joy and just liberty.
I remember so many people thought that the premise was so far-fetched, mm-hmm. rock and roll and dancing being illegal, and yet so many people over the years have come up to me and said, you told our story.
Yeah.
I actually got called afterwards from a town in Texas. I talked to Kevin about it because we almost went down because they were actually banning dancing in their town for just the exact same reason that John's character wanted to ban dancing. And so it actually is very, very relevant, even now.
Even now, yeah.
Was there a reshoot to the ending of this movie?
We beefed up the dancing a little bit, because in the original ending, I come down, I say, hey, let's dance. And,
that was a perfect take of what was in the movie. Yeah,
and it went to slow-mo. And they just found that that the audience really wanted to keep rocking right to the end of the movie. So we went back in L.A. and went on a soundstage and got the haircuts again and reshot some of it.
Was a lot of that improv though, dancing, especially the scene in the bar? Because that looks you're just having a great time.
Lynn Taylor Corbett did a little bit of actually playing with us and sort of seeing what we did, and Kevin and I had a great time, and Sarah and Chris was just amazing.
Passed away a few years ago.
It was brilliant.
Tremendous talent.
Absolutely
tremendous.
Amazing.
Just amazing.
And the scenes of you teaching Chris to dance in that movie are just so...
You know, what's so fun about that is that they really came out of the dance rehearsals that we had and the moves that Chris could do. And he was just, he was so much, in a lot of ways, kind of... That was him in terms of dancing, his feelings about it. He really had never danced at all. And, I remember him showing up at the... rehearsal, and there was the bar and the mirrors and all that kind of stuff, and he had a cigarette and a soda in his hand, and he's doing pliés and stuff with the cigarette. and the choreographer said, Chris, maybe you could just put that out just for the rehearsal. And he said, okay, sorry, that's he had that kind of innocence about him that was just so fantastic.
What's also astonishing, do you have any idea how many small towns across America this play has been put out? How many times do you get calls, or do you hear
every week I get a call or a letter from somebody saying, could you possibly come to the opening? It's it's in a high school in Iowa, and it's
how many have you been to?
Not a lot. I have a new couple. I went to a school, actually my daughter's school, now that I think about it, and it spoke to the cast that was putting together the show.
And gave him a few tips.
I went to see a student production of it, a college production, and my character was played by a freshman who was about 5'2" and 300 pounds, and I sulked all day. Although he was very good.
Because your character just transcends any shape or form. It's bigger than all that. How's that for a good excuse?
I like it.
What do you think about a remake of the movie? There's obviously been a Broadway show, and there's talk of a remake of the movie. Would you guys be in favor of that?
Cool.
Yeah.
Sure.
Cameos?
I would be the old granddad.
Yeah. I mean, I think... I don't know if they're remaking the movie or remaking the musical of the movie following the same kind of pattern that Hairspray did, where you had a movie where they didn't sing, then you had a musical, and then I'm not sure. I would think that they would sing,
Of all the things that you've done, the films that you made, where does this fit in? Is it just a very special one for all of you?
It's a very happy memory.
Yeah.
Wonderful people. I mean, it's ridiculous. Kevin, Laurie, and I became such great friends, and yet I've seen almost nothing of them. It took the Today Show to get us back together.
That's what we're here for.
What was the guy's name who sang the song?
Loggins.
There he is.
Over here. Kenny Loggins is in the studio. Yeah.
Hey, how are you?
Good to see you again.
Kevin. And a special treat, Kenny's going to sing the song for us and another song for us in our next half hour as we continue looking back at the movie Footloose from 1984. Guys, thanks so much for being here. It's a real pleasure. We'll see you in a few minutes as well.
You guys going to hang out?
Yeah.
And party. We'll be back, but first these messages.